Hola, y'all. Happy Wednesday. I'm going to talk about what I was reading. I mean, I just jumped right into it. I don't have much to say. I mean, I worked today and had a good day and went and played bingo with our mama at the nursing home and just loved that, me and the kids. And then went to church. So, yeah, there, I caught you up. I want to jump right into it because this morning I was reading in Deuteronomy. And then we had another missionary tonight, and he's like talking about Fiji and Solomon Islands, and he's, you know, preaching or whatever. And then near the end, he really starts to hit like a sweet spot. And what I mean by that is, obviously, the atmosphere in the room shifted because it was like people responded to something he said. And it was very powerful, something he said. And it was like, it goes along with what I was going to talk to you about and what I read this morning in Deuteronomy. And I was like, oh. And so it really resonated with me because I was already thinking, and I read this morning at 9:17 a.m. It's right there at 9:17 a.m. is when I read. And so he began to talk about forgiveness and repentance. And like he talked about when you're filled with the Spirit, if you go in sin, it's not like the Spirit jumps out of you, like you lose it. And then when you come back to God, you have to re-get it again. And I just thought that was so beautiful. And he was like, no, when you are filled with the Spirit, it is a gift. And it is. And he said, God doesn't take his gifts back. Like, no matter if you fall away and you go to a place of sin and you make a mistake, you still have his Spirit. He said, that Spirit is still in you. And it's just one prayer of repentance away. And he moves right back in and he makes everything okay. And it was just so beautiful. And you could just feel the energy in the room, the Spirit in the room shifted. Because it was just so merciful and so kind. And that's who God is. So I want to read you. I was reading in Deuteronomy chapter 4, verse 31. For the Lord thy God is a merciful God. He will not forsake thee, neither destroy thee, nor forget the covenant of thy fathers. And this is talking about, this chapter talks about, don't make any idols, don't make any graven images, don't bow down to anything. I made the stars, and I made the heavens, and I made the trees and the birds, but you don't make any graven image and bow down to it. I don't want you to try to fashion anything that you think looks like me. Well, number one, none of it looks like him because he's a spirit. But he says, if you happen to make a mistake when you go into the land I promised and you mess up and you fail and you commit idolatry and you do all these things, if you will remember and turn around, I will forgive you. And that's where this verse comes in. For the Lord thy God is a merciful God. He will not forsake thee, neither destroy thee, nor forget the covenant of thy fathers. He is merciful. My thoughts on it. God is way more long-suffering and forgiving than mankind. If we turn to him, he will take us back. And I don't know where this walk catches you in life, but maybe you've made a mistake. Maybe you're dealing with conviction and condemnation from the enemy. Maybe right now you're feeling pretty worthless and you're thinking, God doesn't want me, that I messed up too badly, that I have no place in God's presence. I have no place worshiping him. I can't lift my hands because they've committed sin. I can't do this or that because I'm not pure or clean. But that's not the way God views us. He said, if my people, the preacher quoted it tonight, if my people will humble themselves and pray and turn from their wicked ways, I'll hear from heaven and I'll heal their land and I'll heal them of all their diseases. So God is literally waiting on you in the middle of your mistake, in the middle of your mess up. He's not sitting there shaking his head going, I knew it, or I don't want you. You're dirty. I'm pure and holy. I don't need you. But he is literally sitting there going, please turn. I'll forgive you. I'm waiting to forgive you. Just please turn away from the thing that made you fall. Please. Turn away from that and turn to me and just ask for my forgiveness. It's here waiting on you. That's how God is. Now I know man may not be like that. Women may not be like that. The people you've dealt with, religiously speaking, may not be like that. But God is like that. And He's the one that matters. Because the last time I checked, He's the only one who died for you on Calvary. He's the only one that shed His blood. Application, I put, whenever I sin and I mess up, I won't run and hide. You know, that's what we tend to do. We run away and hide because we think, oh, God can't possibly love me. And no, I'm not just talking about accidental sin, which we can do, or accidentally falling into temptation, which is possible, of course. But this is for the people who sin on purpose. This is for the people who commit atrocious acts and they're very aware of what they're doing. God still offers forgiveness. He still extends a hand of mercy. So whenever I sin and I mess up, I won't run and hide like Adam and Eve did in the garden. When they heard His voice, they knew I've messed up. God just wanted to spend time with them. He already knew they messed up. God knows everything. He saw the whole ordeal. And yet He still came walking towards them in the garden. He came walking towards them in sin. And they went and hid, and He's like, where are you at? And that's what He's doing with us. I said, I won't run and hide. I'm going to come to the throne of grace, and I'm going to ask for forgiveness. No matter what you've done, it is not so horrible or so bad or so disgusting or so vile or so disruptive or so whatever, rebellious, that God won't forgive you. And I want you to know that that is a lie from the enemy to keep you away from the throne of mercy, because He doesn't want you to come. He wants you to run and hide. He wants you to think that you can never be redeemed. And so you give up and you go do worse things, and you go and mess up other things, and you mess up other people, and you mess up yourself worse. That's His goal. And I'm sorry, I'm going to be very blunt here, because if He can get you so messed up that you lose hope, He can get you to take yourself out of this world. That is one of His biggest strategies, is to destroy your life so much that you think it is beyond hope and repair, and then you take your life because you couldn't possibly fix it. And it is such an evil, horrible trick of the enemy. But we're supposed to run to God. My connecting scripture here is 1 John 1:9. If we confess our sins, I love this scripture. If we confess our sins, He is faithful and just to forgive us of our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. And yeah, if we confess, I didn't say that you had to run over there and confess to a man. No, I didn't say that you had to go over there and tell your best friend the horrible things you've done in secret. No, but He said, if you will come to Me, you will confess your sins. You will tell Me what you've done wrong. And you'll turn. I will forgive you. I will wash away all of the filth, all the stains of unrighteousness. And then my last point here, and I'm going to be done. Kingdom. How does all of this relate to the entire body of Christ outside of just ourselves? I wrote, our churches and our relationships should be places of mercy, where people feel comfortable carrying out repentance. You know, I want you to know, I received the Holy Ghost when I was about 9 or 10 years old, and I'm done, I'm wrapping it up. I received the Holy Ghost as a young child. Have I made mistakes since I received God's Spirit? Yes, times 1,000. Have I sinned? Yeah. Have I done things ignorantly? Absolutely. Have I sinned on purpose? Absolutely. Oops, I dropped that. I have. Is it something I'm proud of? No, I'm not proud. But I don't mind being honest with you, because you need to know that you're not beyond repair. You're not beyond Calvary. You're not beyond the blood. The blood will never lose its power. And it covers, love covers a multitude of sins. The blood covers the sins of the whole world. So yeah, I've made mistakes. I've messed up. Yeah, I've had consequences. So no, nobody's perfect. But I can tell you that I make my way to the feet of Jesus on a regular basis, daily, and I ask him to forgive me. And I ask him to wash me in that blood, because I don't want anything separating me from him. I don't want any sin standing in between us. I love him too much. I can't be away from him. And I'm extending that to you today. You have not traveled down the wrong road so far that he can't reach you. The Bible says his hand is not shortened that it cannot reach. All you have to do is turn to him today and ask for forgiveness and change your life. And he will be there to help you every step of the way. And no, I'm not just saying it. I live that every step of the way. I'll see you tomorrow.